Hey, thanks for joining us for Let's Talk About It with Xavier Fox, and I am your host, Xavier Fox. Get ready for this journey. On Monday mornings, Thursday and Friday afternoons, we're going to laugh and learn. We're going to learn other viewpoints on relationships, information on health and fitness, investing, sex, and much more. And today we're kicking it off with Danita Welch and her show, Snatched with Danita. Ladies, she's going to talk to us about shaping garments and how to choose the best one for you. Then I'll interview Mr. Adam Jackson of Allerdorm Cigars. Hopefully I said that right. And talk to him about his business and how he helps others attain success in business. If you have questions on either segment, feel free to zoom in using the link, which can be found on my Facebook page, Xavier Fox, or join the public Facebook group, Let's Talk About It with Xavier Fox, and get all the info. Go to xavierfox.com/radio-show for the schedule of the month of December to see when your favorite personality or topic is scheduled. So let's get to it. Hey, Danita, how you doing today, girl?
Hey, good morning, everyone. Good morning. How are you, Miss Fox?
I am good, getting over a cold, unfortunately, just a cold, but yeah, getting over a cold.
You gotta say that nowadays.
Yes, because you know, anytime you cough or have anything, you know, it's, oh my God. So yeah, but I'm doing great. So what's going on? I'm going to turn the mic on over to you, and I'm going to have definitely some questions because I have a formal event coming up next month, and I got to have this shape, you know, right.
Well, we're here to talk about something that is a big topic amongst women, which is how do I know which compression garment is good for me? And let me tell you that compression garments are very important, especially if you're trying to either lose weight or if you're trying to just look good under your clothes. It's so important. There's so many events that we want to go to, and a lot of times we try on clothes, or we may try on everything in our closet and don't feel confident in what we're wearing because of the fact that our body may not be where we want it to be at the time. Compression garments will give you that illusion that your body is nice and curvy and put in place. So that's why it's important that every woman should have a garment somewhere in their house, in their closet or in their drawer, just to be prepared to wear that special outfit that they want to wear out on the town. So compression garments are really originated because they were worn by top endurance athletes and sports stars. But as you know, most of us use it to not only look good in our clothes, but to aid in losing weight. So, and I'm going to go into why the losing weight portion takes place. So they look like any workout clothing. But just to break down what compression garments are, they're woven tightly to support and restrict your body issues. So your body tissues, I'm sorry. It gives you the feeling of being supported and, as we call it, held in. It keeps us from looking like a can of busted biscuits or something. So your body still has the ability to move freely because, like with me, I wear compression garments sometimes when I work out or even just everyday activities. As some of you may or may not know, I am a pastry chef as well as a body contouring specialist. So all day long, I'm pretty much moving around and doing different things. So it's very important that I am able to move freely when I'm wearing my compression garments. So even if I'm wearing a waist trainer or if I'm wearing a full shaper, some women know it as Spanx, but in the current time, because a lot of women are going through plastic surgery and things like that, we wear what's called a faja, and I'm going to break down what a faja is later in the show. But I wear a faja sometimes. And because of that, I want to be able to move freely and feel comfortable and not feel restricted and not feel all tightly closed up. So that's an important factor in choosing your garment, because you want to make sure that you're wearing something that's comfortable. Hold on 1 second. Let me close this door. I'm sorry. Okay. So I'm back.
Okay.
So So that we don't look like that busted can of biscuits, you just want to make sure that you're choosing the right garment and that you're getting the right size. A lot of women are having issues with ordering the right size garment because either they're ordering them online and they're not actually going somewhere where they could be properly measured and fitted so they can be placed in the right garment. So please take that into consideration. Just like when you go and pick up bras and things like that, a lot of women like to go and be measured because as our weight fluctuates, so does our cup sizes. So does our bra sizes, period, our band sizes, things like that change as your weight fluctuates. So you want to often go and get measured for your bras. So when you go and purchase a faja or a waist trainer or anything Spanx, you want to be measured. And I'm going to go into that as well. Some garments are considered medical grade and are mostly used in post-op surgery to help with circulation and swelling. So if some women have went and gotten any type of plastic surgery like lipo, tummy tuck, BBL, things like that, they would usually put you in a garment when you come out of surgery. That garment is called a faja. A faja is pretty much a full coverage body garment, and most majority of the times it comes down to your knees. Wow. So it's like a Spanx. You would think it would look like a Spanx, but it compresses a lot more than Spanx does. So it comes probably down to your knees, and in certain areas of the body it compresses, and some areas it doesn't. The reason why is because after surgery you end up swelling in those areas. Your body creates a lot of fluid. Your body is trying to heal in those areas. So the fluid causes you to swell, and that compression ends up preventing you from swelling. It helps to actually compress that swelling and help keep you down so that you don't feel uncomfortable. And it helps to speed up the healing process. So fajas basically compress a lot of times in the waist area, so it gives you that nice snatched curvy look. Whereas in the butt area, where you may have gotten a BBL, it gives the butt area that lift. It helps to shape it more, so as it's healing, it's shaping into that look that you want, where it may not compress in the hip area or it may not compress in the thigh area. It compresses in the right areas. That's the most important thing.
Okay.
So a faja has been used, is used during post-op, usually after, in some cases, depending on what type of surgery you get, they'll put you in a faja right away. If you get a tummy tuck, they usually put you in like a binder, which is what we would consider a waist trainer, except it doesn't have all the hooks and all that. It's pretty much just a wrap with Velcro on the end, and it helps to prevent the swelling in the stomach area. So mainly probably about 2 weeks, a week and a half, 2 weeks after your surgery, they ask you to switch over into a faja. You have a stage one and a stage two faja. Stage one is usually the faja that you would go into right after surgery. A stage two is once that stage one compresses you and gets you, you know, the swelling down, and you start to lose weight from the surgery and things like that, and you start to shape and form into how you want your body to look, then you go into a stage two faja. Or stays too high, it compresses as well, but it may not be as much compression, but it still shapes your body like you would like it to. So that's what a faja is. So if you see women in like a full Spanx looking shaper, some of them come with a bra attached to it. It covers the bra area, and some of them come beneath the bust area. So there's two different kinds. You also have a faja that has the arms attached to it, just in case you may have had like arm lipo or things like that, and you need to compress those areas as well. Okay. So now when carrying large amounts of weights, for some of our ladies who are a little bit on the heavier side, you could be susceptible to repetitive use injuries, such as shin splints, strains, sprains, joint damage, and compression. Apparel works to compress muscles against the person's body and their frame to minimize those micro muscle tears caused by muscle vibration and osculation. So me, for instance, I'm a little bit on the heavier side. I'm not that heavy, but I'm a little bit on the heavier side. So, and I work out a lot. So I put a lot of pressure on my knees and things like that. So where they talk about those micro tears, I have a torn meniscus in my knee. If I would have known at the time that wearing compression garments, like maybe knee wraps or things like that, could have helped me and prevented me from getting those injuries, then I would have done so. I learned that after the fact. So ladies, if you're out there listening and you work out and you know you're a little bit on the heavier side, but you're working on getting your weight down, wear compression garments to prevent you from having those injuries. Even if it's a faja under your clothes, even if it's just wrapping up your knees and your legs with ACE bandages, which are also compression garments. You can go to the store and get you an ACE bandage, wrap your knees, wrap your ankles, wrap, you know, areas that you know you put a lot of weight on to prevent those injuries, because what can happen in the long run is those injuries can prevent you from being able to work out. And if we're really concerned about our weight, if we're really concerned about fitness, you know that it is a downer when you can't go and work out.
It sure
is. I know when I tore my meniscus, I couldn't work out for like a good month and a half, 2 months. And it was depressing. So ladies, go get those compression garments and wear them up under your workout clothes. I know it may make you feel a little bit hotter, but go get it. Even if you get you, like a lot of us wear waist trainers while we're working out. It's no difference from that. Just, you know, protect those knees, protect those joints. Because trust me, the older we get, the harder it is to keep those areas from being injured. So just protect those areas, okay? All right. So did you have any questions for me before I move on, Ms. Fox?
Well, not on the faja part, but that sounds like actually a good idea. So even if you haven't had surgery, you can still get a faja?
Oh, yes. We sell fajas at Anatomy Body Bar. We do sell fajas there. And there are numerous amount of places that you can go and purchase fajas, which I was going to actually talk about that at the end on different places where women do decide to go and purchase fajas. But we do have them at Anatomy Body Bar. And as I said before, go and get measured. Don't just blindly purchase. Go and get measured so you can make sure you're in the right size, because if you're in the wrong size, you may not get the amount of compression that you need, and it's a waste of money because fajas are not cheap. Any of those garments aren't cheap. Waist trainers aren't cheap. So you want to make sure that you're being measured properly so that you're getting the right amount of compression and you're getting your money's worth. Okay.
Okay. So I do have a question, because as I mentioned, I am going to a formal event next month, and I'm wearing a gown. Oh gosh. And so, you know, I want that smooth, flowy, classy look. And right now, a few parts of my body aren't really with the plan, so I need to get them in check.
Right. Yes, definitely. So you can wear fajas up under your clothes. The thing about it is some garments are just bulky. Okay. So some garments may have like areas where you have to fasten. You may have like the hooks, and you can see those through your clothes depending on how fitted your clothes are. So they have come out with more seamless options. I know some of you ladies have seen on Facebook the waist wrap, which is like the snatch wrap. That's what some people call it. We have those as well at Anatomy Body Bar, and those are seamless. And I really love them because you could wear them under anything and they go undetectable. No one will know that you have on any type of garment underneath, because there's no hooks, there's no buckles, there's no straps, none of that. It's just completely smooth. And if you really think about it, the idea came from an ACE bandage. Because if you look at it, it's like you're wrapping an ACE bandage around your body. except they just made it wider. They made it more durable, more stronger, because an ACE bandage, it's a little flimsy. After you wrap it a few times, it starts to wrinkle and look weird. But this material that they use for the snatch wrap is a thicker and more durable material. So it lasts a long time. And it no matter how many times you wear it, it gives you that smooth appearance. So that would be an option that I would tell ladies to get, that snatch wrap, because it is just the perfect garment to wear under a fitted outfit, a fitted dress, or anything like that, even a fitted top. Even jeans, things like that. You don't have to worry about that bulkiness of a waist trainer. So that is an option.
Okay, so you're talking about the one I already got?
Yes.
Okay, all right.
Yes, yes. If you, what I would tell you to do is just put it on and put on your gown. If that, and that, it will cover that area, the stomach area of your body. But if you're worried about like your hips, your thighs, things like that, then that's when I would tell you to either go into a Faja or a Spanx. And there are different kinds depending on what type of outfit you're wearing, depending on the length of your dress. And I will go over that as well.
Okay. Well, I'm listening.
So let me just state that while there is no data that 100% backs that these garments aid in weight loss, it does aid in exercise and the exercise portion of your weight loss journey. And the reason why I say that is because you have some women like me who don't sweat that well when I go to the gym. I need maybe a little bit of assistance from the sauna or sometimes a sweat enhancer, things like that. So with this, with any type of garment like the waist trainer and things like that, some of them come with material on the inside that will assist with helping you sweat. When you sweat, a lot of times when you're working out, you're doing your cardio, you're sweating, you're burning calories. The sweat also helps you to release a lot of the water retention, and also it helps you to burn calories. So it's not that the waist trainer itself burns calories for you. It helps aid in you burning calories, which in result, burning calories leads to weight loss. So look into those, if you work out, look into those garments that are specifically designed to assist you in working out, okay? So that's something that's important as well. Regardless of which garment you choose, it is no magic bullet for weight loss, but it does boost your metabolism, and it doesn't boost your metabolism or burn calories, okay? So let's just make that clear. Garments-
It doesn't boost your metabolism?
No. Okay. You do that yourself, okay? So you boost your own metabolism through the foods that you eat, through exercise, through things like that. That's how your metabolism is boosted. Burning calories is based on you and cardio and things like that. That's how you burn calories. There is no garment out here that will do that for you.
Okay.
So it's all in you. So you just got to put in the work, okay? Some garments can assist in helping you sweat, which in turn will burn calories and lose pounds. So that's what I just stated. So garments are used for different reasons, okay? Swelling, post-op, inch loss, to look more put together in your clothes, and to lift and shape your body. That is the main purposes for garments, okay? So if you have any of those issues, if you have anything within that list that you need a garment for, then that's basically why you should purchase a garment.
How long should you wear a garment each day? Like, I wear mine at the gym now, and so I'm there about 2 hours. Is that enough time?
Me personally, I could wear mine a good 6 hour day. It just depends on how I'm feeling that day. It depends on if I'm swelling a lot. I may wear it anywhere from 4 to 6 hours just to help assist in the swelling. Sometimes I wear it just to help me as far as like, I'm already burning calories. So, you know, I consider these garments good for helping to shape and mold your body. So if you're working out and you're already trying to get certain issues, down, like say for instance, love handles or things like that, back fat, bra fat, certain garments will cover those areas and help to compress them. And as you're working out and you're sweating and things like that, it helps as those areas are going down and it's compressing it, it also helps to shape and mold the body. So I would say anywhere between 4 to 6 hours. Some women may do a full 8-hour shift at work in their garment. Some women sleep in their garment, and you can do that. A lot of women post-op after they come out of surgery, they have to sleep in them because they require them to wear them for a certain length of time before they can go without wearing garments. So you can sleep in them, you can work out in them, you can wear them on a day-to-day basis, just doing regular activities. So it's just really up to you and your comfort level.
Okay.
So some garments can assist in helping, so as far as the post-op, so basically that's what those garments do. So that's where, like I said, the faja comes in, the binder. Then once you come out of the binder or the faja, then you go into your waist trainer. So that's where the waist trainer comes in. They provide necessary support in areas of the body that are weakened after a medical procedure such as liposuction, tummy tuck, BBL. Fajas are the most purchased garment due to the increase of cosmetic surgery procedures being performed in and out of the country. But as also you can use fajas and things like that for non-invasive procedures as well. So if you go to a body contouring specialist who does non-invasive laser lipo, vacuum butt lift, cavitation, radio frequency, it's good to go into a garment after that as well, because those fat deposits are being basically destroyed and passed through natural waste. So when you go to the washroom and you pee out those fat cells. So basically your body is going through a change and it's taking shape. So basically your stomach is going down. Those areas that are being treated are going down because those fat deposits are gone. So to wear those garments will help to also accelerate the shape and the form of those areas. So just like getting cosmetic surgery, it has the same benefits for non-invasive procedures as well.
Okay.
So let's talk about the different types of compression. So we have fajas, waist trainers, butt lifting panties. If you haven't seen the butt lifting panties, these are pretty much, they look like they come in a brief or they come in the biker short look, but the butt area is cut out.
Okay.
So that your butt cheeks can come out of the panties. What that basically does is they compress you in certain areas and it allows certain areas to look more plump and voluptuous. So where it may compress you in the stomach area, in the thigh area, and may even the hip area in some cases, it allows your butt to look more rounder and more shapely. It just compresses it in certain areas so you look more shapely in that area. You have some butt lifting panties that don't compress in the hip area, so it allows you that more Coca-Cola bottle hourglass shape where you have the curviness in the stomach area, in the hip area, it protrudes out, and also the butt area protrudes out. So you have more of a curvy look.
Okay.
Then you have the arm and the leg compressions. And then you have the, like I said, the waist wraps and the Spanx. So those are the different ones. And there may be a few more that I'm not speaking on right now, but those are some of the garments that are the most popular and on the rise right now. So to purchase, how to purchase and where? You have so many different outlets because they know cosmetic surgery is such a big thing right now. You have so many different vendors from within the country to overseas in China, Amazon. You have different vendors that are taking advantage of the sudden rise in cosmetic surgery. Beware, okay? Everybody does not sell quality body garments. Mm. For instance, the waist wrap came out and it was very popular on Facebook. you had so many different vendors overseas in China and different places who jumped on the bandwagon and wanted to duplicate that item. So because the companies that were promoting the real top quality ones were selling out and were backlogged on orders, these other companies were taking advantage of, okay, well, we got some too, so we're going to get out there and sell ours. They were horrible. You had women that were paying arm and leg for these items. They would get them. They sort of look like the item they saw on Facebook, but it wasn't. The material is cheaper. It's put together cheaply, and a lot of them couldn't use them. Well, their money is gone. Of course, during the holiday season, you get a lot of scammers. You get a lot of online scammers. So you just have to beware. Try to deal with a reputable company that sells these garments and go with them, okay? Amazon sells garments. I have been guilty of purchasing a garment from Amazon. And to be honest with you, I'm still able to wear that garment today. I love my garment. But you got some garments on there that's just not good. Always read the reviews when you're purchasing online. If you're going through Amazon, read the reviews, okay, on anything that you purchase, especially on garments, because when you're spending your money on a garment, you want to make sure that you're going to be compressed. You want to make sure that you're getting the look that you want. So you don't want something to come in as flimsy, as cheaply made, as poor quality material, things like that. So you want to make sure that you're purchasing something that has been reviewed by multiple women, not just 2, 3, or 4 women. Look for the ones that have been reviewed by multiple women that have given reviews on it and go with the one that has the best reviews. Okay.
Okay.
You also have places that you could physically go and purchase. And those are the best types because a lot of times they will measure you and put you in the right size on the spot. So that's what you really want to do. You want to go get measured. You want to make sure, because a lot of the garments go off of waist size, okay? Waist size. So you want to make sure that your waist is being measured, because on the back of the packaging for a lot of these garments, they go according to your waist.
And so where can people go to get measured?
They can come to Anatomy Body Bar in Country Club Hills. Our address is 4102 183rd Street in Country Club Hills, Illinois. And you can also go, there's a few other places. I know I used to go to a place called Cutie Loops. It's in River Oaks, and they are also Black owned, and they will measure you, and they have so many different variety of garments there as well as different bras. I know they have waist trainers, they have post-op, they have Spanx, they have so many different things. All of the items that different types of garments that I listed, they have them, and you can go there and you can get measured as well. Or you can just go to a seamstress or anyone that measures and just have your waist measured. And then when you go to a facility, you'll know your waist measurement and you can look, or even if you're ordering online, you'll know what size to order because they're going to show you a size chart and there's going to be waist sizes and you'll already know your waist size and that'll make it easier for you to pick and choose which one.
Do you get an accurate measurement if you do it yourself?
You could possibly, yes. If you know exactly where your waist is, a lot of women don't know the difference. They think that down right above your hips is your waist, but it's really not. It's above, it's right in the lower abdomen area. So it's like a lot of women don't really know exactly where your waist is. And because of that, your measurements can be off.
Okay.
So if you go and get measured, then that would be the best way to do it. Also, I was about to say something, but I just lost track. But yes, go get measured. Just also be aware that garments are going to be a little tight in the beginning. So don't think that you got the wrong size. As long as you're able to pull it up, just know that compression is what it's there to do. So it is going to be a little bit fitted. it's going to be a little tight in the beginning because your body has to get used to wearing it and it has to be used to being on your body. So just give it a little time. It will loosen over time. And as your body is starting to go down in size, that garment will get looser. And because a lot of the garments have like four layers of hooks, four rows, you start off usually on the first row. As you go down a little bit, you go to the second, third, fourth. When you get down to the fourth row of hooks and that starts to become loose, that lets you know that it's time to go down to a smaller size garment because you have come down enough to where you don't need that size that you had anymore. So that's why they call them waist trainers. That's why they call them, you know, trainers, period, because what it does is training your body to get to a certain size and a certain shape. And if your body gets down to that, then it's time for you to go down to a smaller trainer. So that's what it's doing, is training your body. So yeah, just make sure that you get measured. That's the most important thing about buying any type of undergarment, is to be make sure that you're being measured properly.
So I have a question. I think I might be putting my wrap on the wrong way. Mm-hmm. Because when I sit down, it folds up. Am I putting it down too low?
It could be possible that you're putting it down too low, or it may not be tight enough in that area. It could be that it's not tight enough in that area. And it could also mean that you're not overlapping it enough, and that there's a gap there to cause it to. So maybe you can come and see me and I can take a look and I can see how you're wrapping it yourself, and I can give you some suggestions. Okay, but you want it wrapped firmly, like I said, just like an ACE bandage. Imagine when they wrap you in the hospital or at a doctor's office with with the ACE bandage. They wrap it pretty firmly. They don't leave any areas that are loose at all. So you want to make sure that you are wrapping yourself nice and firmly. The whole key word is compression. So you want it to compress. If you're not wrapping it firm enough, it's not going to compress.
Okay. That's like my issue. I feel like I'm not necessarily wrapping it right. So I'm going to come in for a little mini class.
Oh yeah, definitely. Now let's talk to you ladies about how to keep your garment in shape. Okay. The biggest problem is women put their garments in the washing machine. That's a big no-no.
Uh-oh.
Big no-no. From bras, we always try to figure out, why is my underwire coming out of my bra? Why is my boning coming out of my waist trainer or my, It's because you're putting it in the washing machine and the dryer, okay? So what is meant for us to do, a hand wash with maybe like some Woolite in the sink, or if you have to use the washing machine, just please put it on a delicate cycle. These are delicate garments, okay? So we want to make sure that we can keep these garments as long as possible and get the most use out of them, the most bang for our buck. If you are constantly washing on regular cycle, your undergarments, your bras, your waist trainers, your fajas, because all of that has boning in it. Over time, the threading and everything that they do to stitch it will start to wear thin. And then that boning starts to come out of your garment. Your favorite bra, we all have one. When that underwire starts to come out, we're hurt and we're upset because you can no longer wear that bra because now you got lopsided boobs because you got one side that's missing the underwire and the other side that's still intact. So you might as well just throw it away. Let's preserve our undergarments by not putting them in these rigorous wash cycles. If you're going to put it in the washing machine, which I don't suggest, I would say do a delicate cycle with some Woolite. But if you can hand wash your garments in the sink, in your wash sink with some Woolite or something like that, and let them hang dry, let them hang drip dry. Do not put them in the dryer. All of that puts a lot of wear and tear on your undergarments.
Okay. Now I do let mine hang dry. I tend to let my clothes hang dry. because I think the dryer is pretty harsh on most stuff. But the hand washing, yeah, I don't know.
So let's help keep our garments in shape so in return it can keep us in shape. Okay, ladies?
All right, that sounds good.
Yes, so that is the slogan. Keep it in shape so it can keep us in shape. Okay? So, as I stated before, garments are, you can find garments, you can go online, you can Google them. But like I said, beware of scammers. This is the season for it. A lot of women have ordered stuff. Oh, and also because of the shipping delays, we're still dealing with that as well. So if you're ordering anything from overseas, just be aware that in some cases you may not get it when you need it. So just try to support your small local businesses and see if there's any places in your area or in the surrounding areas that may sell body garments and waist trainers and things like that, and support them. You have a lot of women that are out here that are starting their own business, and you know they're doing the waist trainers and things like that. Support them, okay? So, but also go in and see if they can measure you, as I stated before, so that you can get in the right garment and you can be comfortable. Now, some waist trainers aren't comfortable. Okay, they have to be broken in. When you first put them on, the material is a little tight, so it's gonna feel like you're suffocating a little bit. But just know that the more you wear it, the more it will have a little give to it. You just have to give it a little time, but it will feel tight in the beginning, but that's what you want, because like I said, the key word is compression. So you want it to compress. If it's too loose and you can fit two fingers down into the top of your waist trainer or your garment, it is too big.
Oh, okay.
You should not be able to comfortably slide your fingers into the top of your waist trainer. If you're able to do that, it is too big. If you see wrinkles in your waist trainer as you're wearing it, it's too big. Okay, you shouldn't be seeing wrinkles at all. You shouldn't be seeing any type of room in that trainer. It's too small. So go and get measured properly so you can be in the right garment. Okay, they also have garments out, like I said before, that will compress the arms and the thighs. I know we have some women who complain they got those thunder thighs and our arms look like wings. That's gonna help us fly away. So they do have garments that you can get specifically for those areas. They have like these wraps that you could put around your arm, and you can Velcro them. And they also have the material on the inside that helps you sweat. So if you work out, while you're working out, those areas are sweating. They also have sweat enhancers that you can purchase. We have sweat enhancing cream at Anatomy Body Bar that you could put underneath your waist trainer. And me, I like to take it a step further. I like to put my sweat enhancer on, some Saran wrap, and then my waist trainer.
Okay.
So what that does is that helps me sweat more, and I even get in the sauna that way as well, which helps to enhance my sweating, which helps to help me to burn more calories while I'm in the sauna. So that is a great idea for ladies who want to sweat more in those areas to help get those areas down. Get you some sweat enhancer. We have sweat enhancing cream. You can also invest in, there's a company called Sweet Sweat. You can get you some Sweet Sweat. I think they sell it at GNC and a few other places, or you could probably go online on Amazon and find Sweet Sweat. I know back in the day, the boxers, to get down to their fighting weight, they used to use what's called Abilene. Abilene is basically a makeup remover that you can buy from CVS Pharmacy, Walgreens, Walmart, in the cosmetic area. It helps to remove makeup, but it also has, it looks like Vaseline basically, but it also has different elements in it that helps you sweat. So a lot of people would use that around their stomach underneath their waist trainers to help them sweat. I used to use it and it works just fine. Oh, so if you need to, get you a sweat enhancement cream. Drink a lot of water, because with anything that allows you to sweat more, you can dehydrate yourself. So make sure that you're wearing that you're drinking a lot of water when you're wearing those type of items. And even when you're wearing your fajas and your waist trainers and your garments, make sure that you drink a lot of water. Okay. Another key thing about the fajas, which I love that I forgot to mention, there's a hole at the bottom for you to pee. I love it. So what I do is, because if you rush into the washroom, it's easier for you to make a little mistake when you go tinkle. So what I have is what's called a funnel. I don't know if you all have heard of the funnel, but you could buy it on Amazon. It's a feminine funnel. So it's a little funnel that actually cups around your vaginal area. And if you, it's meant for women that's out in the woods. If you're out on a camping trip and you don't want to be in the woods squatting in the bugs and everything, you know, this funnel, you can use it and you hold it up to your vaginal area and it pees through the, you pee through the funnel and it comes out like a stream, like as if a man was using the washroom.
Oh, wow.
So it makes it easier. So what they taught us in the non-invasive and the invasive cosmetic surgery world is they recommend to a lot of women who are getting cosmetic surgery to get a funnel, because a lot of times they're in pain from the surgery and it's hard for them to fully sit down, depending on what procedure they've gotten done, if they gotten a BBL or if they got a tummy tuck or liposuction. So this funnel allows them to use the washroom. They don't have to come out of their faja, because the minute you come out of your faja, you can swell. So they recommend that you stay in this faja 24/7, but it's like, okay, how do I pee? So there's an easy access hole at the bottom of the faja, which allows you to insert the funnel in that hole and pee through the funnel.
Oh, wow.
So that's another thing that would be great for you ladies to get if you're out and about and you might be at an event and you got a really nice outfit on and you don't want to run and try to come up out of this faja or, you know, underneath your dress, because it's a lot to come out of. And depending on how you put it on and depending on how it's constructed, it may be hard to come out of it. And if you have to pee really bad, you need to have an easier solution. The good thing about the funnel is it comes in a really nice, pretty satin bag with a drawstring that you can just throw in your purse. So it's not like this giant thing that you pull out of your purse. It folds up. It's like it's made out of, I want to say, rubber or plastic or something. So you're able to fold it and put it in your satin pouch and keep it in your purse. It's undetectable. No one notices that you have it. So it's something great to have with you to be able to go to the washroom and not create such a big mess trying to get this garment off. And now you're peeing on yourself and you're trying to come out this garment and it's taking a long time. So this makes it easier.
Wow. So that's where do you get those?
You can order those on Amazon. Actually, the one that I have came from Amazon. It's really pretty. It's a little purple funnel. They come in different colors and it comes in, like I said, a little black pretty satin bag.
And so you just go on Amazon and type in funnel or urine funnel, or
you could type in feminine funnel or vaginal funnel, female funnel. You can type those keywords in and it should come up.
Okay. Oh, wow. Okay. I kind of like that idea, period.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Oh, it's great for women, too, who don't like sitting on public toilets.
And that's me. That's why I just said that.
Yes. If you don't like sitting on public toilets, this is the item for you. So, yes, get you one, ladies. That's a little inside tip. Get you a funnel.
That's a good one. Yeah, I like that.
Yes. So once again, ladies, you can come, and gentlemen, you can come to Anatomy Body Bar. We're located 4102 183rd Street in Country Club Hills. We specialize in body contouring. We also sell a lot of the garments that I listed to you, as well as sweat enhancement cream, body detoxes. So if you want detox teas, we have all of that as well. We also have included a few services. So we have 2 makeup artists. We have a lash extension tech. We have an esthetician that specializes in facials and skincare. And we've also just now added in the foot detox service. So we also offer that to help to detox all of those toxins out of your body. And it comes out through your feet. It's a very relaxing service. We offer that with our V-Steam service. So as you're sitting and you're getting your steam on and you're drinking your champagne or your wine, you can also do your foot detox as well. And we are in the process of offering a few more services. So I just wanted to let you all know that you can book with us at www.bagaro.com/anatomy body bar, and body is spelled B-O-D-I-I. You can book with any of our technicians, and we hope to see you soon.
So I had a couple questions. I got one question because I'm not sure I asked this in the beginning, and especially for those who may have missed your launch show back in October. So how did you get into this?
Actually, I was actually a customer myself. I had a little Indian lady in River Oaks Mall that I used to go to, at the suggestion of a friend who went to her as well to get different services, body sculpting services, and she was great. I saw results right away. And at that time, there wasn't a lot of machines that were being used. They only had like certain machines that had came out. This was a new thing that they were doing. The Kardashians had made a big, hoopla over these services. So now people was running out trying to find these services. So I wanted to try it out myself. I was a little bit overweight from having children, and I wanted to see what I can do to help kickstart my weight loss journey, try to get some of the swelling down, things like that. And to be honest with you, it really helped a lot. And I always said that I wanted to do this for a living, but at the time, the machines were very expensive, and it just wasn't in my budget to do so at the time. As time went on, years went on, more companies made it easier for us to obtain more different types of machines that didn't cost as much. And I was able to get my first machine, and me and my daughter, we decided to start, taking classes and learning how to do body sculpting and understanding the body more and why body contouring is very beneficial to the body. And it really sparked my interest even more. I decided to jump full-fledged into it a few years later. And here I am. I have my first facility in Country Club Hills. I have a staff that's very good at what they do. And our customers are happy with their results. And they're able to go on after their services and follow through with the different things that we've taught them and informed them of to keep their bodies maintained. And some of them even come back and see us for maintenance appointments. So yeah, it's a really great industry to be in. Women learn a lot of things about their bodies that they didn't know. A lot of people come in skeptical because they say, oh, we don't know if this works. But when they leave out, they have a totally different understanding. So they know that it works now. So if you are curious about if these procedures work, we do have specials at our facility that you can come and try out. It's a one session special. And once you come and try us out, then from there, you can book packages with us and do multiple sessions at a time. We can help get you ready right now for the summer. This is a perfect time to start coming in and getting treatments if you want to get yourself swimsuit ready for next summer. This is the time that you start. Please don't wait until it's closer to the summertime. You want to start now.
Okay, I guess those are good gifts to give for our listeners if you have a wife or a sister or a girlfriend or whoever. Do you guys have gift certificates up there at Anatomy Body Bar?
Yes, you can purchase gift certificates on our website, the same website I just gave you for booking, www.vagaro.com/anatomybodybar. You can go on there and purchase virtual gift certificates for your loved one, or you can just give us a call at 708-924-2639. And you can give us a call and we can work something out with you and walk you through the process of purchasing your virtual gift certificate. Or you could just book something and send them in for a service.
So I have a question about that foot detox, because I know everybody, just like me, has probably seen on Facebook, on social media, people with the foot detox, and they put their foot in there and the water's clear, and then, you know, some minutes later it's yellow, and then it's brown, and then it's black. Yes. Do you actually see that?
Oh yes, definitely. I do it on myself. And I have seen that as well. So yeah, you deal with a lot of toxins in your body due to stress, due to just different things that you put in your body, food, you know, alcohol, drugs, tobacco, different things. So I want to offer this service to you guys, because when you see the way that this water changes colors, you'd be like, oh my God. A lot of people don't believe it until they see it, how much toxins their body actually carries. So this is a great service. It's not an expensive service, but it's a great service to add on to any other service, or just do it by itself, so that we can start working on better health practices with your body and getting your body together. So that is something that, you know, wellness is something that really is important to us. So when I first did the detox on myself, my water turned like a copper color. So wow. It's like, I'm like, oh my God. It's like almost no one has a clear end result.
Wow.
So the whole thing is, yeah, let's start working on better health practices. Let's start working on a healthier lifestyle. Get those foot detoxes. Let's start on a detox regimen through foods, and get you some detox tea, and let's start flushing these bodies out, ladies and gentlemen. It's so important.
And you said you get the foot detox along with the vaginal steam?
Yes, you can do it with the vaginal steam. Yes.
What if you just want the foot detox?
You can do it by itself, but I mean, we offer it because you're already sitting and you're steaming, so we can just put your feet right in the foot detox. But if you want to do it by yourself, that's perfectly fine.
Okay. All right. I'm going to have to give you another visit. You got to teach me how to wrap my wrap. And yes. I definitely want to try that foot detox. That has always looked interesting. I want to see what comes out. Mm-hmm. That sounds so interesting.
Yes, it's definitely worth trying out. And like I said, as far as the waist wrap, we want to make sure we get you all the way together before you have this event. So let's get you in to look at some different Spanx options, some different fajas, and let's see what we can do about getting this waist wrap together, and talk about maybe getting you a few services in before your event, so that can help give you even better results.
All right. Well, we definitely gonna have to check it out, because I want to look like $1 million when I haven't worn a gown since I haven't. So I don't really like long, but I'm going with a friend, and she told me we're wearing long, and because I'm a little short, so long just kind of emphasizes how short I am.
That's okay.
I'm gonna put on my heels, and I want to have just that sleek hourglass figure going on.
Yes.
I have been wearing my wrap, so I do actually have the hourglass figure going on. It's just not smooth. From the front, the shape that you see looks great. But from the side, you know, I had a cesarean, so back in the day. Matter of fact, today is my oldest daughter's 38th birthday.
Oh, happy birthday.
Yes, so I had a C-section with her all them years ago. So they didn't do the smiley face cut. They cut right through that muscle. And so I've been, dealing with that little pudge. Sometimes the pudge is smaller than at other times. But for this formal event, I don't want that to show up at all, if possible.
Okay. Well, we can definitely work on that. So come see me soon, okay?
I will. It'll probably be later this week for sure, because next week I'll be out of town. So I will definitely see you sometime this week. When are you up at Anatomy Body Bar?
I am there Monday, some Mondays, because Monday is actually my off day, but I do come in on some Mondays. But mainly Tuesday through Saturday, but I work by appointments only. So whenever I have someone scheduled, I'm there.
Okay. So that just means that I need to call you. And it'll probably be Wednesday. I'll probably come through there Wednesday.
Okay, yes, definitely. So yes, call me, let me know when you're ready, and I am there.
All right. Well, this was a great show, very informative. I know I always get into my personal business on the shows, but you know, and everything is so relative to real life, so it's so easy to do that. You know, I mean, this is real life stuff. You know, women, we do this stuff all the time so that we feel good and feel sexy and stuff. Because if you feel good about yourself, you know, that confidence comes out and life is just great. You're just happier. There's a spring in your step. So all of these things add to your self-confidence and stuff. You know, there is absolutely nothing wrong with feeling good however you get there. As long as it's legal and not addictive. You know, we don't want any addiction type stuff to try and feel good. Unless it's sex, maybe. I don't know. Anyway, this was a great show. Do you have any final words for your listeners?
Yes. If you go to our website and book an appointment up into the 20th of December, we are giving 30% off on our body, on some of our body garments, as well as certain services. So laser lipo, vacuum butt lift, bee steam, teeth whitening, and the list goes on and on. We are giving 30% off of those services. It expires on the 20th of December. So please get in. Let's get our holiday bodies together. Let's get our teeth whitened and get ourselves together for these holiday parties that are still going on. So if you call us at our spa and book an appointment, or if you are interested in being a part of our Melon, our email crew, which is when we sell out, send out our promotions, it goes to all of our customers. It's like a mailing list. You can do so by giving us a call, 708-925-2639. That's 708-925-2639. You can give us a call, and that's also in regards to the gift certificates as well. But take advantage of that 30% off. And in some cases, we have some items that are 35% off. So please give us a call. Take advantage of those garments, because you may want to wear a garment for the holiday, for Christmas, when you gather with your family. Let's get you in some garments today. So just give us a call, 708-925-2639.
All righty. Well, great show, Danita. And I am looking forward to seeing you later this week. And everyone out there listening, make sure you stop by Anatomy Body Bar, get measured, get your undergarments, or the other place you said. What was that other place you said?
Cutie Loops.
And that is where?
It's in River Oaks. It's not in the mall, but it's, if you look it up, it's called Cutie, C-U-T-I-E, and then L-O-O-P-S. It is Black owned by a sister. She's really nice. She will measure you as well, but she is on 159th and right before you get to Torrance Avenue. Okay.
All right. You know, that is great. I love it when we all support each other. And so you're not looking at her as competition. You actually gave her a plug. I love that in you. I love that in all of us. We need to support each other. So, okay. Today is December 13th. If you are listening to a replay of this show, be sure and catch the live shows, which are on Mondays from 7 to 9 a.m. and Thursdays and Fridays from 12 to 2. So stay tuned. And our next special guest up is Mr. Adam Jackson. And we are waiting on him to enter the studio. So we're going to listen to a little music until he makes his way on in. I am Xavier Fox, and stay tuned for more of Let's Talk About It with Xavier Fox.